I suppose this is as good a spot as any. No point in going any further tonight. The world I know is far enough behind me now. I went to the woods because I wished to live deliberately, to front only the essential facts of life, and see if I could not learn what it had to teach, and not when I came to die, discover that I had not lived. I did not wish to live what was not life.
I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. Well, what's the point? The wind blows out of the gates of the day. The wind blows over the lonely of heart, and the lonely of heart is withered away.
The fairies dance in a place apart, shaking their milk-white feet in a ring, tossing their milk-white arms in the air, where they hear the wind laugh and murmur and sing, of a land where even the old are fair, and even the wise are merry of tongue. But I heard a raid of Culminating say, when the wind has laughed and murmured and sung, the lonely of heart is withered away.
Huh. It must have all just been a dream.
The horses of the sun goddess begin to mount over Midgard. And there, I see the light of destiny points down and shines brightly upon this mortal. Yes, a map of the Aeshetha.
This is turning out to be a perfectly normal morning.
Look about you, mortal. The fairies visited you during the night, and entrusted something special into your care.
by virtue of their judgment, that you are worthy of the task. Lo and behold, the fairies of Hodnir have bestowed upon you their most powerful and well-guarded secret. A most powerful secret.
Whoa. What?
The map there, placed at your side. It is the only map in the entire cosmos that discloses the long-concealed route to reclaiming the lost crown jewel of all elemental magic.
You are here on account of destiny. The threat of the Drawns has directed your path to Hodnir Wood, so that the fairies would appoint you, Tom Bradford, as the custodian of this highly coveted parchment, and grant you access into the sanctum of their forest dominion.
How do you know my name?
Tom Bradford. In all the nine worlds, there are so few secrets that elude my single eye.
Nearly nothing escapes the far-reaching scope of my knowledge.
And yet, there are a few pieces of the cosmic puzzle that remain a vexing mystery to me. Like the content of that map at your side. And the forest of Hodnir itself that is before us, where the map now leads you.
A realm forbidden even to the gods of Asgard.
What is going on here? Who are you?
Throughout the vast stretch of the cosmos, Tom Bradford, I am known by many different names. The keeper of the ancient Sadia magic. The thief who stole the meat of poetry. The guardian of the rune spells. And there are some who simply call me the Wanderer. The one who wanders freely between all the worlds.
Between the worlds?
Yes, all nine of them. In whatever form I choose in my endless quest for knowledge. You see, Tom Bradford, I have an insatiable longing to understand everything there is. And it was my own eye that I sacrificed to Mimir in my thirst to consume the waters of his well. And garner from them unlimited wisdom.
Is that so?
Yes, and it was also I who for nine windy nights hung from that eternal tree of the heavens. There I learned the secret of the sacred runes.
Though I know their secret, I did not create the runes, nor their magical forces.
I do not have any power over the ultimate source of their magic.
I really don't understand. Could you break it all down in simple layman's terms? I'm sort of at a loss right here.
Tom Bradford, listen to me. I'm already explaining that. Pick up that map and follow me this way.
This map reveals the hiding place of the long-lost Ord Runestone.
What is this thing, Runestone?
The Ord Runestone, the original and most sacred of all the so-called Runestones. It is the source from which the runes derive their power.
What exactly are runes?
You see, these are runes. The runes are the visible expression of the secret essence contained in all the elements that have ordered the cosmos since the beginning of time.
There are many stones engraved by the hand of men with the markings of the sacred runes. Stones used to channel their forces through magical spells. But there is none like the Ord Runestone.
So, what's so special about this runestone?
The power of the runes dwells within that stone and can never escape it. Anyone who possesses the stone is capable of seizing control over the operation of all the elements.
What happened with it?
Many years ago, the warlock Zoroastro
obsessed with wielding the Ord Runestone for his own malicious ends, managed to trespass through the Well of Destiny and stole the Runestone from the altar of the Stone Temple outside of Hardmere, where the gods had secured it many eons before with the agreement that only a neutral mortal could enter it when needed to prevent the gods from a power struggle. Zoroastro stealthily brought the stone into Hardmere Forest, where no god could find him. So, for a period of time, enclosed within the secrecy of the forest, Zoroastro sought to gain mastery of the stone's power. When the elements of Hardmere began to succumb to Zoroastro's sorcery, the fairies came to realize the grave danger of what he was attempting to do under the cover of their woodland. So, the fairies used their magic to snatch the runestone from his grasp and sealed it up inside a magical fairy circle, where it would remain hidden until the fairies could find a mortal to retrieve it. All the while, it is believed that Zoroastro made a pact with a spirit of the wood and was sheltered somewhere inside the forest, waiting for the moment when the runestone would reemerge from the fairy circle. If Zoroastro
could learn to harness the mystical energy of the Ord Runestone and bend the elements of the cosmos to his own will, all he would have to do is wait for Ragnarok, the fatal destruction of the worlds and the gods that is destined to occur. He would be invincible with the stone in his possession, and no gods, no giants to contend with him. Regardless of my fate, I must do everything I can to ensure that the next age is ushered in with the hope for renewal.
This is... I don't even know what... I cannot be the right person for this task.
Who are you, Tom Bradford, to call into question the word of Ord, to argue with the will of the Norns, the decree of destiny? It is inerrant, and you must answer to it now.
I don't know. I don't know how I can.
The ravenous wolves prepare to devour the sun and the moon, and I can feel the icy winds of the mighty winter arising out of misty Niflheim. As the fire giants begin their thunderous march to battle, the brewing storm of Ragnarok is at hand, Tom Bradford. You must make haste.
Wait, stop. Don't go. I don't even know what I should do.
Go. You will find the entrance to the forest through a grove up that way. But before you do, Eroin, the gatekeeper of the woods, will find you. Show him the map, and he will grant you safe passage into the woods. And beware, Tom Bradford, the wizardry of Zoroastro. He is cunning, and he is most determined in his quest for power. He will stop at nothing to retrieve the Ord Runestone. That must not happen.
Who dares trespass into the woods of Hardmere? What? A man? A foolish man?
Yes, I'm a man, but who are you?
I'm Eroin, the gatekeeper to the woods of Hodmir. What are you doing here?
I was told to go this way.
Outrageous! Trespasser! Told by whom?
Some man who calls himself the Wanderer.
What? The Wanderer? No, that can't be right. No one would call himself that. Wait, did he have but one eye?
Yes, that's right. And he looked quite old and a bit taller than you.
Are you mocking my size?
By no means.
Never underestimate an elf. And that was no man if that really was the Wanderer you were talking to. But why would he speak to you?
Well, apparently because I have this map.
What? The map to the Ord Runestone? But how could you have... It couldn't have passed into your hands without the fairies, without them choosing you. But why you?
I have no idea. In point of fact, I still haven't even gotten over how dumbstruck I really am about all of this.
I don't see what it is, but I guess fairies can see things that elves cannot. No shame, though. We elves have our own special knacks. about the map.
Yeah, can you take it? I really don't want anything to do
no,
with it.
No, I cannot take it. If the fairies gave it to you, then you and only you can guard it. You must seek out the secret location of where the fairies hid the runestone.
This is really too much. I came to the woods hoping to find something, but not this. I just wanted to go and live like Thoreau in peace and harmony with nature and all that crap.
Oh, how you mortal fools babble on. There cannot be peace as long as the runestone is not secured on the altar of the stone circle. You must retrieve it.
But where? How?
Open up the map. Tom, we are here at the beginning of the forest. Along this path, you'll find Berwick, the dwarf. He will provide you with something that could help you along your journey. Here's the fairy circle. This is where the Erd runestone is hidden. Somewhere along your journey, Serona, the horned druidess, will find you. She will help you navigate to the fairy circle, and she'll just explain to you more about it. Once you have the Erd runestone from the fairy circle, you must eventually come here. Here's the stone temple in the Well of Destiny, just outside the forest. This is where you must restore the Erd runestone on the altar within the stone temple. This is where your journey ends. Now stay out of trouble and move swiftly. Farewell, Tom Bradford. You will find Berwick the Dwarf before midday.
Bear what?
Berwick. Now farewell.
Where'd he go?
Human in my woods? Does he have it? No. Oh, I must tell Master. Master.
What is it, you fool? I am busy.
There was a mortal in the woods.
A mortal? Where?
He was off in the woods,
And did this mortal have anything particular in his person?
He had a parchment, that of a map.
A map? Was the parchment at all aged?
Yes, Master. Almost as old as you.
Shut up, you fool!
Oh, I'm sorry, Master.
Oh, don't be sorry. This is the best luck we could have. This map may be the one to the runestone, you idiot!
Oh, Master, that's good.
I want you to follow this mortal.
Follow the mortal, the keeper of the parchment. Let him lead you to the Orr the Runestone. After he retrieves it, you are to kill him and take it from him. And bring it to me. If you fail, do not bother returning.
Yes, sir.
Here. This may yet prove one day to be of use to you.
Can I open it, Master?
No, don't! Don't open it until the time is right!
All right, Master. How do I know it's right?
You will know. Now be gone with you, you idiot!
Greetings, mortal. I can't recall the last time I've seen your kind here.
Are you Berwick the dwarf?
Yes, I'm a dwarf and my name is Berwick. You must be here for some kind of special business.
Yeah, something special.
Is this the map?
It's a map to that one runestone thing.
The Ord runestone?
Yeah, that thing.
Fairies hid the runestone years ago. You must have seen him.
Yeah, I do believe I have.
He sacrificed his eyes for the waters of wisdom. I don't have anything of that power, but I have elixirs and potions that will help you through your journey.
Really? So, what's this?
That is an apple.
Oh.
But here, I have the finest honey and elixir. It will restore your powers of mind if you fall under a spell. There are strange forces in these woods.
So, all I have is a 5. Do you have change?
Oh, we don't take mortal money around here. Here in Hodmere, our currency is gold, which my brothers work for in the mines.
So, I don't have any gold.
Well, speaking of gold, since you're on a journey to find the Ord Runestone, which is made of the purest gold, for your troubles, I will give you these for free. Have the blessings of the fairies. You are a friend.
Well, thank you.
Would you like this apple and honey on your journey to the Ord Runestone?
I might end up using it. I might as well. Well, I guess I'll be on my way then.
Oh wait, one more thing. This is the blood of Nidhogg. It may help you encounter any danger on your journey.
Blood of what?
Oh, Nidhogg. It's the dragon that feeds on the World Tree. Its blood is so potent that it can kill anything.
Well, I hope I don't mix it up with the elixir then.
No, you don't want to do that. May fortune smile upon you.
Morto is asleep, I see. Time is now.
thank God. The map's okay.
Okay.
I'm not angry. I'm just disappointed.
Oh.
Get up! I said get up!
Okay.
And don't forget the map!
Alright.
Get the map! You are on a very important quest.
So who are you?
I am Sirona, the druidess of the forest. Some call me the horned druidess, as you can see.
Why is that?
Because I have horns.
Oh.
Yes. You know why you were chosen for this quest, Tom Bradford?
I haven't the faintest idea.
You are very special in the eyes of the fairies.
I, even though I am a druid, cannot see it.
I don't see it either.
The fairies, they choose what they want.
Yes, they do.
Very few mortals get to see Hobbin before.
It is not very safe during these times. The Rostro is on its path to getting the Runestone's power.
The Rostro can do anything to get his hands on that Runestone. Theragon has turned against the Forest to aid the Rostro in his plan.
So, who is Theragon?
Theragon is the green man of the forest. He is what helps everything grow. Theragon would do anything to gain a little bit of the power that Zoroastro will have. That is why it's your job to go into the fairy circle to save our world.
How does a fairy circle work?
The fairies, when they need a portal to go to their realm, they dance and it creates magical mushrooms that go in a circle and allows them to transfer to their world. Or they use it to protect something.
How am I going to get into this fairy circle?
First, you take these three runestones. and you place them underneath the mushroom in a triangle pattern. You do know what a triangle is.
I have a general idea, yes.
Okay, with the fairy's permission, which I assume that you have. And then, once you enter the circle, you will be whisked away into their realm to find the brimstone.
And how will I get back?
You'll just go back the way you came.
Okay.
Now go. Go follow this trail all the way until you see a circle of mushrooms, and do exactly as I told you.
And Tom Bradford, if you need my help again, I will find you.
But how?
I just will.
But are you sure you can't come with me? I don't like the idea of going in a fairy circle alone.
Tom Bradford, go. Now!
Okay.
Now! Mortals. I don't know what they see in him.
Is this it?
No. No, that's not it.
Oh, the final circle! It's left! Will the help!
Did an owl just talk to me?
Well, the goat! The fairy circle! Just throw the help!
I suppose this shouldn't even surprise me, considering all the stuff I've seen.
Look, fairy circle. Just throw the help. Just keep on going. You'll see it. Giant mushroom in a circle. Can't miss it!
Okay, okay.
Fairy circle. Oh.
Master will be very pleased.
By the power of the runes, you hold the key to enter this magical ring of the fairies.
By the power of the Ace Sheetha, I, Gwiodolin, unlock the portal of the fairy circle.
Tom Bradford, I am Uladwin, the winged fairy. You are in the secret realm of the fairies where everything is enchanted. Do not take anything from here. Find the large oak tree in the sacred grove behind you. There is a golden pine cone with a rune near it. In the hollow of the tree, the Ord runestone lies. When you remove it from the hollow, place it with the map. After that, you will be transported back into the forest. Follow your path south, Tom Bradford. I will cross your path soon.
Must be what I was looking for.
Congratulations, Tom Bradford. You have acquired the stone.
Now go. Turn this way, up onto the path.
Follow this path for a little ways. We will cross over onto a hill. In order to be the stone altar on the hill, you must put the stone in the stone circle. And your quest is complete.
Okay, then.
Farewell, Tom Bradford.
Farewell.
Keep your wits about you, Tom Bradford.
But first, remember to make haste. Zoroastro is still about.
Okay.
Go! I said go!
Mortal fools.
I hate when those mortals come into our woods.
Spirit of the woods.
Okay. Why did you jump out from behind that tree?
That stone you have is very important. If you'll give it to me. It's one of much importance to the woods. If you take it out, all of the woods will die.
That's not what the wanderer said. He said I have to return this to...
Do you just believe every random creature you see?
Well,
by the gods!
Oh, creature!
Die!
Foolish mortal. I told you to go fast and avoid everything.
Yeah.
Go. The stone temple is not much farther. Put the Ord runestone on the altar and your quest is complete. Don't follow anything else. Don't talk to anything. Don't do anything. Just go and hurry and don't be stupid. Foolish mortal.
Wait, where did he go? Tom Bradford. You were looking for something in the woods, and you got more than you bargained for.
Beware, Tom Bradford, of the will-o'-the-wisp. The beautiful light will ensnare you in a spell that will lead you to your death. Just ahead, you will come to a crossroads after you pass through two trees. Beyond that, you must use caution on your way out of Hodmere. You will pass through a corner of the woodland, bewitched by evil forces and black magic. Be careful, and may destiny protect you. Guard the runestone, Tom Bradford.
Restore the runestone to the altar. Follow on your quest.
I'll be on my way then. Thank you.
What is
that? The twilight of the gods. The world will be consumed. And ice, and then fire. Ice, and then fire!
Is that the whatever? Enveloped in darkness, led to the light. I'll be back for you. And what is that?
Second time I've heard about Ragnarok.
Oh. Come. You there, fool! While we meet!
Yes.
Haven't had food in days.
Here you go, sir.
Yes. Thomas, to a new age of gods and monsters.
Yes. What new age is this?
Oh, but it is a new age when the wolves devour the sun and the moon, and Zoroastro, me, I shall reign supreme. Mommy! And be sure to top off Thomas's glass.
Sir, can you put the glass in the thank you. Thank you.
Stop bumbling!
I'm sorry.
Oh. Wait, I think I've heard that name before. Are you Zoroastro the Warlock?
Zoroastro the Warlock. Zoroastro the Exiled. Let me tell you why I am called such. I have been taking refuge in this wood for many years. Hodmere is now more of a home than a refuge. I've been waiting patiently, Thomas. Patiently to get my hands on something. Something you may know about.
What is that?
Let's not go into that right now. How about a story? I always love the one about the sly old trickster Loki. Yes, the wager he once made with a couple of dwarves.
When Loki was so audacious to claim that no one could ever create anything to rival the sons of Ivaldi's craftsmanship, the dwarven brothers, Brok and Sindri, heard this claim and were outraged. The brothers took up the challenge and proposed a special wager to Loki. Brok bet that if the brothers proved that their skills were indeed superior, Loki would have to lose his head as the price.
Did you hear me? I said his own head!
That cost more than an arm and a leg.
Yes, quite so.
And so the wager was settled, and the dwarf brothers went to work in their underground cave. Though Loki tried, with all of his cunning, through various shape-shifting ploys to frustrate the brothers in their work, he was unable to prevail. The brothers succeeded in forging these wondrous treasures, unmatched by anything ever before seen in all the cosmos. The magical golden arm ring, the boar of glowing sunfire, and of course Mjolnir, the hammer of thunder, judged by the gods of Asgard as indisputable proof that the brothers Brok and Sindri were indeed the greatest craftsmen of all. So Loki was forced to concede defeat, and therefore his own head, as he had agreed. But when Brok happily drew his sword and prepared to sever Loki's head, the sly trickster protested that it was only his head that had been wagered, and the brothers had no claim over his neck. And as no one could exactly agree where the head ended and where the neck began, the gods of Asgard had to agree.
Loki was able to keep his head. More mead, friend.
I know it could be rather addictive. The honey is most gratifying.
Mead bores me. Fetch wine!
Yes, sir.
You know, to say the best trick that I have ever played was against the Norns. I was able to blind them.
I said I would not give back their eyesight until they allowed me access
into the well.
And through the well of destiny, I was able to get my hands on that runestone.
That runestone. I'd become the most powerful being in the cosmos. And so there I was, in this very same wood, and I was learning its secrets. Beholding its power. And then the bloody fairies and their spells and trickery. They locked it away, deprived me of it. They sealed it in their circle. Oh, their fairy circle! And I have been waiting ever since that moment to take its power. Waiting for whoever...
Whoever would receive the map?
Elixir. It will restore your powers of mind if you fall under a spell.
Yeah, the runestone. I've been waiting for it for over a millennia. Where is the map, Tom Bradford?
I left it in the...
Yes, yes. Left it where?
In the fairy circle when I got the...
The fairy circle! It is you who has the runestone! Where is it?
Where are you going, dear Thomas? Where are you going?
Nature calls.
I don't think so. You see, there is nary a wizard more cunning, more majestic than the great Zoroastro, and you're going to see the full extent of my power. So try to slither away, but don't forget to look up.
The blood of Nidhogg. It's the dragon that feeds on the world tree. Its blood is so potent that it can kill anything.
Yes.
What is this?
Mortals, you never learn.
What is this? You!
I need you to go after him, you fool!
No. I've had too much meat.
Enough excuses!
No, please.
Useless mortals, how? I summon from the depths of Niflheim the spawn of the fierce wolf's blood!
Straight to the stone temple. Follow this path. The exit to the forest is that way. You'll find the stone temple on a hill. Place the runestone on the altar. Then your journey is complete. Now go!
Entire life, I have waited to get my hands on the runestone.
No, Zoroastro!
The runestone is mine, you fool!
Zoroastro, I have the power to fell a god. No, the powers of all of Asgard is against you now, Zoroastro. You are made to meet your end right here. This is the well of destiny.
That's not happening!
Yes, you know the well of destiny there. You have been through it before, and you're going to go down the well of destiny one more time! Zoroastro, though your thread of the dawns is cut! Destiny awaits you!
Tom Bradford! Return to the stone circle, place the runestone on the altar, and your task is complete.
And always remember, Tom Bradford, it is the light of destiny that is your true guide.
Mortal fools.
I hate when those mortals come into our woods.